An Auckland bus driver was critically injured after he was assaulted by a bus passenger in Waterview on Wednesday night. It was the second time in under a month that this bus driver was attacked. On August 29th, the same driver was assaulted on Railside Avenue in Henderson. And according to the police, during lockdown, there were 35 incidents of abuse and aggression towards bus drivers. Does more need to be done to protect our drivers? For more, we're joined by the president of the Tramways Union, Gary Froggat. Good morning, Gary.
Good morning.
Gary, we won't go into detail about this attack, but we do, of course, know that it was brutal. He was put in hospital. How's he doing?
He's currently in a stable condition, but it's going to take some time for him to recover.
And second attack in a month. Geez. I mean, what are his colleagues saying? Have you heard from other bus drivers? Does this make them more fearful about their own safety?
Well, we have been inundated with calls about their concerns, and we're calling for more support. Auckland Transport have said that they are willing to provide more support, and we're yet to see that that happen.
Yeah, what would adequate support look like to you?
Well, we think there should be more Auckland Transport officers riding the buses. The police and Auckland Transport have just completed a educational video saying that they're going to travel on the buses much more frequently. We're also calling on Next Capital, who own NZ Bus, to provide workshops. Personal safety workshops. We think that will help the situation, but we're not getting a great deal of support from NZ Bus in relation to our safety concerns.
What has their response been?
Well, they've said they're willing to support us, and we had a round of stop work meetings earlier in the year to discuss this with Auckland Transport, who did attend our meetings. However, we haven't seen much action since the beginning of the year when we held those meetings. And since then, there's been a whole lot of assaults on drivers, as you heard, 35 in the last month or so. And there's been a number previously to that. And we believe that by involving the employees much more, that will bring home and get the feedback from the actual drivers.
Mm. Yeah, this is 35 drivers that have faced abuse or aggression just in the lockdown and just in Auckland alone. I want to know, is that a figure that has gotten increasingly worse perhaps under the pressures of lockdown?
No, I don't think it's got any worse. It's lucky we don't have much more, given the thousands of trips that are run every day. I guess some people have been frustrated, but in this particular instance, it was absolute coincidence that the same driver was involved. And that makes it much more worse, I think, in drivers' minds. Now, they work long shifts, 14-hour days in some cases, and they're always worried about what or who gets on their bus, et cetera. And under the COVID situation, there haven't been a great deal of passengers travelling. And I think that their concerns are still there, and we're going to get a backlash, I think, once we get back to work and out of COVID in relation to this particular incident.
Look, we're interested in keeping in touch with you, Gary, and seeing how that response goes. But we do appreciate you and thank you for your time, and to you and all your colleagues, take care and thank you for being a part of our essential services during this time. We appreciate you. Thank you very much, Gary Froggat.
You're welcome.
From Tramways Union.